Well, Macklemore has certainly come a long way since celebrating bargains at his local Vinnies. His latest track, a fiery protest anthem, taking the world by storm. Macklemore releasing a message of support for Palestine and student protesters. Occupying the quad is really against the law. And the reason to call and the police and their squad were the genocide land and your definition. The track, Hinds Hall, hitting 29 million views on X and more than 117 million on Instagram in just 72 hours. Macklemore calling out the music industry. If the music industry's quiet, complicit in their platform of silence. And even the US president. The blood is on your hands, Biden, we can see it all. No, I'm not voting for you in the fall. Reactions have been split. Critics reviving accusations of anti-Semitism against Macklemore in 2014, which he denied, while others are singing his praises.
Macklemore is not one of those artists that when he says something, everybody listens. So to get as much love and praise really just indicates that there's a big void there with mainstream artists who do have that global reach.
The song, another in a long line of iconic protest anthems championing everything from women's rights to Indigenous land rights and the fight against police brutality. But most of those anthems are decades old. True protest songs now few and far between.
I think that artists self-censor themselves because they understand what they need in order to keep this fairly insecure form of employment together, and it's not by upsetting half of the audience.
So could this be the beginning of a fresh recording studio resistance?
I think there will be more musicians who feel emboldened to talk about it. You always have examples of brave and courageous artists that do put their hand up and then lead the way, and I hope the Macklemore song does that. You want the world to stand up and the students finally
did. Let's do it. Yeah, there's undoubtedly a key element of bravery in there when you're an artist standing up writing your protest songs. But I do wonder if social media has killed the protest song. If, you know, the protest song really used to give a voice to a generation or to a gender or to a group of people. Now everyone's got a voice on social media. Who needs a song to do it? You can just get out there and, you know, write something on socials and everyone can see it. So do you really need a protest song anymore?
Well, I also wonder if actually, like, I get the courage argument, and I'm not saying there's no courage in this, but I wonder if it also makes it, in a way, not as courageous as it would have been in the past, because social media silos everything. So there are a whole lot of people who are ready to, they're already on board with this. Mm-hmm. And I would guess, I don't know for sure, but his fan base would probably be more politically that way than...
I guess, yeah, it's hard to know, but
so
I would
say
think
he's
so.
Playing to his fan base.
No, I'm not trying to say he's being cynical. I don't mean this as a personal thing. I just mean structurally.
Yeah.
Like, you can release a song like that and you know, you're kind of assured of a response that will be positive in a way. Mm-hmm. That maybe you mightn't have been when Midnight Oil were doing Beds Are Burning.
Yeah, right.
You're saying it's not as big as a risk as you might first think it could be.
Yeah, or as it used to be.
Yeah.
But I could be totally wrong about that. Maybe next time we have him on, we'll ask him.
Yes, I think we'll have to put it to him.
Where's Taylor Swift's protest song?
Well,
she protests all those bad relationships all the time. Equally important, in my opinion.
Watch the rage. Watch it.